As we all know, manufacturing in the dimensional stone industry is very hard on equipment. Equipment is exposed to mineral particulate, a harsh water environment, or other oxidation-causing elements. This is in addition to the typical wear you see from the tool connection process, making it all more important to maintain your tooling. In this video, we're going to talk about two components, the pull stud and the tool holder. The pull stud is critical to pulling the tool into the machine spindle. It experiences high pressure and clamp forces from the drawbar inside the machine. You should frequently inspect the pull stud for cleanliness and wear. There are two main areas of the pull stud that you need to pay close attention to. The first area is the head, or this diameter right here, where the gripper will actually come over top of. And then on this particular pull stud is the underside of the head. So this angle right in here is where the gripper fingers actually make contact with the pull stud and pull the whole tool holder back into the spindle. You'll see in the examples to follow, we have several areas that particulate or other minerals or dust, debris from the process will actually build up inside and underneath this and on this head, causing interference with the fingers to grab and pull that retention knob. If not properly cleaned, that debris will actually cause an interference between the fingers and the pull stud and cause damage to either the fingers or the pull stud. So in this example, you can see there's particulate that's stuck up underneath the head of this part, causing an interaction between the pull stud and the grippers to deflect. You see the ridge, you could see some of the other contaminants in the way, again, causing a pinch point and potentially damaging the retention knob or the gripper fingers. In these two examples, you can see permanent wear or even deformation marks underneath that head, suggesting that these pull studs are wore out and need to be completely replaced with brand new pull studs. Using these continuously will cause wear to your gripper fingers and other parts of your drawbar system inside the spindle. This is an example of that pull stud cleaned up after. And as you can see, the underside head, after all the particulate is removed, appears to be in a good finish. No major chips, dings, dents, whereas the fingers can still come in and make a good contact point on the pull stud. Now, the best way to check and maintain your pull studs is using some type of light, non-abrasive Scotch-Brite pad. They make several different densities of these that you can get in there and it'll scuff that particulate off the pull stud without actually removing any raw material on the pull stud. Tool holders also have an important feature that makes connection with the machine spindle that you have to properly maintain and inspect frequently. This taper across the end of this tool holder, once the drawbar pulls the pull stud into the machine, mates the taper to the taper of the spindle, causing a high pressure interference contact. What's important is to make sure there's no particulate elements, debris on this surface that will otherwise get smushed in between the spindle and the taper. Not properly maintaining this or keeping this clean can cause a few different issues in your machine. One being runout or chatter that you'll actually see in your cutting tools in the material you're cutting. So it's very important to keep this clean. So while you're inspecting your cones and specifically your taper, there's a few things to look for. One, you'll be able to see as the tool holder wears to the spindle of the machine, the main contact points of where the machine and the spindle mates. Each machine will be a little bit different, but you'll see the shiny areas of the contact. When you're inspecting them, it's important to run your finger or a rag across them to feel for raised edges, contaminants, particulate, anything that would cause an interaction or runout in that connection. This is an example of a cone that is due to be cleaned. It's still relatively in good shape, but is needing to be cleaned and removed to be able to continue using. This is an example of a cone that's probably towards the end of its life, and if you put a tool in it and checked runout, you would see some type of runout caused from the damage on the cone. Captured in this, you can see small little deformations from where material or particulate was caught between the spindle and this tool holder, either causing dents, dings, rises, or even damage to the spindle of the machine itself. You could see up towards the top where the machine tries to remove or push that particulate away, but ultimately still traps it at the edge, causing damage at the end of its connection. This should otherwise be removed and recycled and replaced with a new cone. In this example, there's two cones, very similar in age. One is before, one is after. This cone here, you can see, has been removed from the machine. There's contaminants, particulate, there's buildup on the cone and needs to be removed and cleaned. On this cone, you can see, like the retention knob or the pull stud, we used the Scotch-Brite or some non-abrasive pad and cleaned the cone up to remove all that particulate, leaving a nice, clean, smooth finish where the taper makes contact with the spindle. This is what you want your used cones to look like in order for good operation. In some instances, tool holders might make contact with each other, things may bang into your tooling, causing dents and dings on your tooling. That's okay as long as you identify it and remove any ridges. In this example, you could see something had collided with the taper, causing a slight ding. The important part, if you identify these, is to make sure that none of that area that's been dented is raised up above the material around it. If this dent protrudes upward, where it may make contact with the spindle first before the taper does, that will cause issues with runout and needs to be removed from the tool holder. Routine preventative maintenance will not only prolong the life of your tooling, but your machine as well. And cleaning that tooling frequently with non-abrasive pads such as Scotch-Brites will help with that. And remember, using worn, damaged tooling will cause damage to your machine and cause poor finishes in the stone. I hope you found this video to be informative and give you enough information to inspect your tooling today.